COVID isolation rules are likely to be cut from 7 days to just one for vaccinated people who are exposed to a positive case. State Cabinet is yet to debate the move, but we can exclusively reveal it's already been signed off for tennis players and staff heading to Sydney for the ATP Cup, so it can go ahead with minimal disruption.
After driving 2 hours from the Central Coast, this cricket fan found out the hard way.
Match is off.
The Sheffield Shield game was this morning called off and the entire Victorian team put into isolation in their Bondi hotel after bowler Will Sutherland returned an inconclusive COVID result.
I'll still get me a pint of beer, mate.
It won't be an issue repeated at the ATP Cup in Sydney next year. 10 News First can reveal vaccinated players and staff have been granted different isolation rules if they're exposed, and it may soon apply to all of us. The State Cabinet likely to pass a new rule allowing vaccinated people who come into contact with a COVID case to isolate only until they receive a negative test result instead of 7 days.
My expectation is that will be discussed at our COVID and Economic Recovery Committee meeting next week.
It would also apply to children too young to be vaccinated, reducing the lengthy list of school closures. Today, another 15.
Because there will be positive cases in schools, but we don't want to close them for a substantial period of time. I don't want kids sitting at home. I want them in the classroom.
The rule is already in place in Victoria, where restrictions were eased overnight, allowing dance floors to reopen. And they've gone further than New South Wales, scrapping density limits in hospitality entirely.
The reality is there are very little restrictions or very little difference between 2 square metres and no limit.
Not so, says the Hotels Association.
It's 50% of our trade, so we're talking about a significant difference. Look, we're seeing low continuing case numbers. There hasn't been a significant increase since we reopened fully, so it's about time that we got back to normal trade.
But New South Wales may move ahead of the other states and become the first to remove QR codes in low-risk settings such as retail and cafes.
The reality is if the vaccination rates remain high and infection rates remain low, yeah, we should have a discussion about removing them in low-risk environments.
And while no date has yet been set, there's hope it will mean that last-minute Christmas shopping won't require a check-in. Ursula Hager for 10 News First.